One sunny, fine day, the hare was in the park, telling all the other animals how fast he was, bragging and boasting as usual, telling them all that he could beat anyone in a race.
Uno look pan me! You see me fast! I fast me fast, inner! You can't come fast like me! He's boss me now, boss, inner! He just fuck me, I tell you, no fuck, trust me!
He ran up and down the field, real fast, to impress all the other animals. Man, he felt good. He felt real good.
So if you think on a bad, come race me, no? Race me! Make a show you who fast. Any owner come race me right now!
All the other animals look the other way. They didn't want to look at the hare. None of them wanted to compete.
Yeah, man, I ain't doing that.
Because they knew they had no chance in beating the hare at a race.
Look at them! Them all too afraid to come and race me because them know semi is the fastest.
Out of the blue came a little voice from the background, from a tortoise. And he said,
I'll have a go. If nobody else wants to go.
Said the tortoise.
What? It's queer, queer. It must be queer, queer. You are come challenge me? Furious. A turtle.
Well, you know, I don't mind taking part in the race. You're afraid you might lose or something.
Hey, Harriet. If no realize, are you seeing them call me? You seeing firebolt? I no realize that. Somebody tell him, Femino man. Tell him.
Some of the other animals began to laugh at the idea of a hare running against a tortoise.
All right. Turn a circle, yeah? All right. Look. We not race today. We are going to race tomorrow, all right? We are going to give you a little time to get ready and exercise, yeah?
Everyone was too afraid to say something and didn't believe that the tortoise had a chance against the hare. They were all shaking their heads saying, this is crazy. How can a hare battle in a race with a tortoise? This is madness. The next day, just before the race, the hare came and was stretching and practicing and was very sure that this was going to be an easy race. And everybody was there waiting. The whole crowd, all the animals in the park, waiting for the tortoise to come along and to take part in the race of the century.
Oh, yes. All right, me ready. He's ready, me ready. What were me ready for? Me, I go beat him. This race, I go easy. I mean, me, the fastest animal in the West. They call me Firebolt against a little turtle tortoise. What you call it? Turtle tortle. When my way they call him. Me, I go win this race. Easy, man, easy.
The tortoise just arrived. An hour late, as usual.
Good morning, everybody. I'm really sorry I'm so late. Well, I'm here now. I'm ready for the race. And I think I'll win this race.
Okay, let's get this race on the road. On your marks. Get set. Go!
Yes, I got me, sir.
In a flash, the hare was gone and left the tortoise at the starting line. The tortoise plodded along real slow, and just kept going and going and going. While the hare, he was running fast and looked behind him, and he saw the tortoise just plodding along, and he was laughing all the way. The hare was so sure that he was gonna win the race, he decided to stop at the corner shop to eat some food.
Look, Yana, this race is a no competition. Me can't stop very little lucky and selfish, yeah? Because me a go win this race anyhow. Me can't go stop here some man and sit down and have some food.
Can I help you, mate? Can I serve you?
Give me 2 dumplings, lucky and selfish.
Okay.
And I want some breadfruit as well.
Okay.
And put in another dumpling there so for me,
right,
man.
Okay,
man. And I drag and stuff.
The tortoise kept going and going and going. And just kept plodding along all the way to the end of the race. The hare ate so much food, he fell asleep. Wait a minute. There's the finishing line and nobody could see the hare. All we could see was the tortoise plodding along and coming along right next to the finishing line. Where's the hare?
Oh gosh, boy, that food there, boy. Full of me belly, boy.
Wait.
Wait, at the finishing line, wait, make a run go catch up quick.
The hare just woke up, but he was too late because the tortoise was just crossing the finishing line and the hare was way behind.
No, man, he can't go so. He can't go so. Wait, hold on. He can't go so, man. Oh, gosh. Oh, man. The tortoise. He win the race. He can't go so. He's cheating, cheat. Just because me have little food and he full up my belly. He cheat.
Oh, well, I never thought that I would win, but I tried. And I managed to win the race! Oh, I'm so happy!
Nah, man, it's cheating, cheating, man!
Oh, I'm so tough! Oh, none of you believe
me! No, don't go so, man! That's cheating,
that I would win the race!
Dear man!
No! Well, I won the race!
We can race again tomorrow! We can race again!
And so it was! The tortoise had won the race! Amazingly, he bit the hare, the greedy hare that stopped off for food. Nobody thought that the tortoise would ever win against the hare, but he did.
So kids, I hope you understood that story. It doesn't matter who you are. If you try, you can win. And that's exactly what the tortoise proved today. Thanks for listening.